I want to give you an overview today of how to deploy printers to users in a network. We will assume that the employee workstations are connected to the same network. One option is to connect the printers locally via USB or parallel interfaces to a workplace computer and then share it. And this is how the printer is shared. At Devices and Printers, you see all the installed printers. The HP printer should be shared. To do so, I right-click with the mouse on the printer and select Printer Settings. In the Printer's Settings window, I click on the Sharing tab and activate the checkbox Share this printer. Other workstations on the network send the print job over the network to this workstation. This renders the print job and sends it back to the shared printer. For this to work, connect each of the other workstations to the shared printer on one workstation. And there's the HP printer already available. With the shared printer scenario, the operating system of the computer workstation basically acts as the print server. The operating system of the workstation receives the print jobs from the other clients, saves these locally, and spools them one by one. Pretty easy, but unfortunately not that efficient, especially for large companies. The workstation connected to the printer must be always switched on. If that isn't the case, then nobody else can print. That's why a better option is a printer that has its own network interface. Now everyone can always print from various workstations directly to the printer. And this is how network printing works. The workstation formats the print job and sends it via the network to the destination network printer. This then processes the print job and initiates the printout. So that's how it works in general with network printers. What's even better though is to use a print server. Print servers haven't the best reputation, but in fact, many print servers can be eliminated. Find out in our next video about the benefits of print servers and how they can be consolidated.